ESPN presents an NCAA basketball triple header starting at Carver-Hawkeye Arena, where the unbeaten third-ranked Blue Devils of Duke make their first ever visit to Iowa to battle the 5-1 Hawkeyes. Duke has dominated the Big Ten teams. They've beaten them 9 straight times as Coach K tonight goes for a milestone, win number 400. Terrific triple header of hoops, so bag those plans to go Christmas shopping. After our first game, we'll take you out to Maui. One of the Maui Invitational semifinals, Jared Prickett at number 5, Kentucky. We'll battle Derek Anderson, Lawrence Funderburk, and the Buckeyes. That's at 9:30 following game one. Then following SportsCenter, we'll be back for the second semifinal. Boston College playing the good defense, ranked number 18, unbeaten. We'll meet Arizona with the powerful offense. Khalid Reeves, 32 points against the Irish. So settle back and relax. Meanwhile, at halftime of our first game, we'll keep you posted on the ballgame in Fog Allen Fieldhouse between Indiana and Kansas. And reminder that Cherokee Parks and Duke coming up right after this. Brad Nessler and Dick Vitale will have the call. We'll see you at halftime.
Man, we're a different team.
Playing here in Iowa, they're better here at home. They'll be a better team.
Big cast around me in Grant Hill and Tony Lane. We got a lot of maturity, so I think it's easy for me to do a little bit more.
They just loved playing Duke, and what Duke's accomplished, we're all proud of. That's a great series of accomplishments, and our fans are excited about the game.
A full house at Carver-Hawkeye Arena in Iowa City. Cold outside. It'll warm up in here in a minute as the number 3 Duke Blue Devils take on the Hawkeyes of the Big Ten. Hi, everybody. Happy holidays. I'm Brad Nessler along with Dick Vitale. Dick, you know, we got so used to Duke winning the national championship when they didn't a year ago. I think everybody thinks they had an off year and maybe they're down a little bit. They're right back there, number 3 in the country.
Well, the reason they're right back is they have Mr. Grant Hill, the best all-around player in America. He can play 3 positions. He's multi-dimensional. And he makes everyone around him better and better. And the guys around him, Brad, can flat out play. Cherokee Parks, the big guy, 6'11", shooting 67%. And Tony Lang is a new player. They're big, baby. They're big.
That is the key word, a decided height advantage all the way across the line as you take a look at Iowa in the gold, Duke in the blue. Every position, the Blue Devils are bigger. But Tom Davis, the head coach of the Iowa Hawkeyes, says he will use that to his advantage.
We're so small and we're so quick that they're going to have trouble keeping up with us. So we got to, you know, we do have a problem matching up and we face that. But then also, let's go to our strengths and our running game and our fast break. Are they going to be quick enough to get back?
Iowa does know how to run. They know how to play pressure defense too, Dick.
Well, they've really changed their philosophy now, Brad. What they're doing is shooting the 3, baby, shooting the 3. I'll tell you, they're exciting. And I'll tell you something else. The eternal optimist is Mr. Davis.
He has reason to be optimistic. This building, listen to the crowd. They were 15-1 here a year ago. They've got a 43-game non-conference.
ESPN's exclusive coverage of NCAA basketball is brought to you by Bud Light. If you want great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light. And by Walmart, always the low price. Always.
We get set for the Duke Blue Devils and the Iowa Hawkeyes here in Iowa City. Duke comes in unbeaten at 5-0, thanks in part to Grant Hill, who is a very, very different type of point guard. In fact, his head coach, Mike Krzyzewski, says you probably don't even want to call him that type of player.
Grant Hill is not a point guard. Grant Hill is a heck of a basketball player. And my concern was that everyone was calling him a point guard, that that's only who he would try to be.
I've had the responsibility, some of bringing the ball up the court. But the main thing is we have to have other guys help me bring it up, and I think you'll see a little bit more of that. At first, I think we were so used to just having one person bring the ball up the court, and this just team is different.
And Grant Hill heads our tops starting lineup with Capel joining him in the backcourt, Meek, Parks, and Lang, the group up front. For the Hawkeyes of Iowa, Jess Settles, only a freshman at 6'7", but he has really come on in the last couple of games, joins Murray, Winters, Glasper, and Bartles. Iowa is 5-1, Duke 5-0, and 42 straight non-conference home wins dates back 6 years.
A
I'll tell you, certainly a great winning streak, but Brad loaded in there. It's been a few cupcakes. This will not be Cupcake City tonight, playing the Duke Blue Devils. But a different look, Iowa team. Certainly a team that'll play quick, and they're going to play very, very fast offensively and shooting the three.
Lenny Wirtz will toss it. We're underway in Iowa City, and immediately Murray and Meek end up in a collision. But it's Duke in the front court. Parks takes the shot over Settles, who had slipped, and Parks immediately with the first 2 points.
What a great touch, shooting 67% in his first 2 years at Duke. Shot 62%. That's the best for a first two-year player in the history of the ACC.
That's an amazing stat when you think about it.
He's got to assert himself a little bit more offensively and want to shoot the ball. Man-to-man defense by Duke. A lot of help. Winters is the key guy. He's the driver and slasher.
Glasper on top, leads the club in assists, and we're under 10 on the shot clock. Capel on Glasper. And now they're going to have to hurry. Bartles will have to pump one up. And nail the three.
That's the kind of play you have to have when you're an underdog. You have to have really every guy making the big shot. And there's the full court pressure.
17th three of the year. Bartles leads the club in that category. I don't think he would have taken that one if he didn't have to, but he buried it.
He's had a lot of injuries in his career from out of Freedom, Wisconsin. There's that zone defense. They like to play with Tom Davis. Communicating, matching up.
Hill works for a jumper and got it.
Tremendous touch. Has really improved his range as a shooter. Was not a three-point shooter. Went 3 for 3 against Michigan. The Fab Four Wolverines are 0-4 against the Dukies.
Nice feed inside. Bartles found some room and drew a foul. And it's Tony Lang who is trying to help out underneath. It looked like he and Hill were supposed to switch and somebody didn't get the message.
Bartles was a little slow going to the goal. He was wide open on a little horizontal cut across the lane. This Duke team is so big. What a unique team. Now you look at Duke with the great size. Bartles averaging 11 points a game. They had one loss down at Hilton Coliseum. Have you ever done a game there?
No.
Down at Iowa State. I've never been there. They tell me it's a special place.
Yep.
Johnny Orr's team is undefeated.
They were down by 9 at one point and down by 11 at one point. Actually came back and had a 2-point lead with about 3 minutes to play in that one, but they were fighting uphill the whole second half as Bartles missed his opener. And he's got a chance to draw even. That one rattled out too.
Parks certainly one of the premier post players in America. In fact, the ACC has three outstanding post players, Montrose, Sherrone Wright, and also Parks.
Capel trying to feed over to Meek, stolen away. First Duke turnover.
That's the real concern of Duke, handling the basketball.
Setting up outside, Murray.
They're not going to waste time, baby. It's trifecta time here at Carver-Hawkeye Arena.
The Hawkeyes with a pair of threes and a 2-point lead.
Very important they get the early lead to get the crowd really fired up and into this game.
You told me that before we tipped it off, and boy, did you call that one, because the crowd was almost asleep in the warm-ups. They aren't now. Hill has a three rattle out. Winners a rebound. It'll be a 2-on-2 unless he gets some help.
He's a Skywalker, loves to drive.
Murray will take another one outside and drew a foul. And it's Tony Lang. Antonio Lang, two quick fouls here in the first 2.5 minutes.
And he's been their most consistent player. Last year, he was a Dow Joneser. He was up and down, but he's worked really on the weights. He's like my stocks, baby. They go up, they go down.
Got to wonder if Mike Krzyzewski is going to go to the bench and get Lang out of there with two. And about the time we say that, Marty Clark's up. So Antonio will probably sit down in between free throws as Kenyon Murray from Battle Creek, Michigan, steps to the line. And so far, Iowa's 0 for from the stripe.
He was Mr. Basketball out of Michigan, and they've really been a very successful program recruiting Michigan. B.J. Armstrong, now star with the Chicago Bulls. Roy Marble played on Dr. Tom's first team. They were 30-5.
Finally, Murray snaps the long drought of free throw misses by the Hawkeyes, and it's Iowa 7-4 and another Duke turnover.
Yep. Grant turned that ball over, made a real mistake for an experienced player bringing it up that sideline.
It's a problem they had late in the game with Michigan, and you can bet that Iowa's going to try to go after that part of the Duke game.
Well, everybody with any kind of quickness is going to try to attack Duke.
Winters lobs, Parks swiped it out of midair.
Tough play to make, throwing it over 6'11 guy in the lane.
That's right.
There's that zone. You're going to have to make some open shots.
Hill all alone, nails a three.
He can knock it down. You know, everybody talks about him not being a leader, not being verbal. He happens to be a quiet guy. Not everybody can be extroverted and introverted like I am.
Thank God.
Exactly. You got to be what you are. I was talking to Mike about that today. Krzyzewski, you know, the kid leads by performing. That job is to perform.
Settles, the freshman will sit. Russ Millard will check in. Millard battled Settles, who's talking with Tom Davis now for the starting spot, and just through hard work, Settles, the man that won the position, but they'll share that time. They're the two biggest guys, really, Iowa has on their team.
There's a different look in terms of Iowa and their offensive sets. They don't have the post player, A.C. Earl, like last year.
Winners, nice drive.
He's a driver. He's a slasher. He's their leading scorer and rebounder, 6'5".
Iowa 9-7.
There's that full court trap. That's where you want to do. Post somebody, then attack the glass. Go to the board.
Meek will keep right on going, but he walked with it. And if he wouldn't have walked, he probably would have been called for a charging violation.
I'll tell you one thing. Mike Krzyzewski said it today. We're going to have to come to play. This team is going to be very tough here. There goes Meek with a little walking. A little walking music. There's the drive by Winters, splitting the defense, protects the ball really well, gets that nice finger roll, 6'5". They call him the Skywalker.
Settles on the floor right now to get the left shoe tied. Rather, Winters does as Settles comes back in. Duke's got three field goals, but three turnovers. And Parks out, and they're looking at his ankle, it appears.
Spoke to his granddad today in a hotel. What a proud guy. Went to pick up his mother at the airport in Kansas City. Told me he's got a little granddaughter that watches him all the time on a tube.
And he is really in some pain over there on the Duke bench with the left ankle or the left shin. Underneath, Millard trying to get position on Meek.
What a real tough cut by Millard. A strong diagonal cut. He goes across the lane. I'll tell you, they're playing really fired up basketball.
Collins, who just checked into the lineup. He and Clark on top now. Here's Meek. Nice feed underneath from Kaper. Meek missed it, but he drew a foul.
Meek might be their most improved player, but you got to remember, he came into college really at a real handicap, had that problem with that leg surgery, got hit by a drunken driver. That just reminds me, I hope with the holidays, that everybody out there uses some real sanity in terms of deciding whether to go behind their wheel or not, because we certainly don't need any major accidents because some people decided to drink too much.
Mm-hmm. Meek steps to the line. Eric, 6'10 junior, Escondido, California.
He's an excellent low post player. Comes up empty on a free throw line. He really helped his game this summer. Played for the ACC All-Stars, he told me, and they went to Canada. And he was one of the few big men, so he had to get a lot of minutes, and that really helped his game.
Only a 53% free throw shooter so far this year.
I'm pumped up. I think we're going to have a good game here, Brad.
It certainly has gotten off to a good start. Iowa leading 11-8, and we're 4 minutes in from Iowa City.
Is that pressure that Duke likes to apply? Deny one pass away, help in the lane, give help to one another.
Barber's nice feed in low. And Settles walked, trying to get underneath for a reverse layup. Second turnover against Iowa. We've got a timeout. 15:43 to go first half. Iowa's jumped out to a three-point lead. Cherokee Parks on the Duke bench and apparently has had his ankle worked on. We'll see if he comes back in. The left ankle was giving him trouble.
Brad, before we go any further, we certainly want to send our best wishes for a speedy recovery to Bobby Hurley as we look at the free throw line right here. One of my favorite players. Bobby, they love you so much. Everywhere I've been going in this arena, everybody's been saying, send our prayers and best wishes to Bobby Hurley. Get ready. We want you back. You're really one special little guy, the best all-around point guard I've seen in many years, the all-time leader in assists, a real winner.
Right now, the Blue Devils trailing by three. Clark had a notion to try to tie it up. Nice defense right now by Iowa. Collins will try to tie it and does.
He can shoot the three. He almost came to Iowa. That was his second choice. In fact, he roomed with Chris Street, the former Iowa Hawkeye who was killed in that tragic accident. And they became such close friends during his recruiting visit.
In low, the double team, and still getting the shot off. Iowa out undersized, but doing a good job on the boards, and that's been the story for them so far this year.
They're really having a lot of success with that diagonal horizontal cut across the lane. They do an excellent job coming to the post area, and then they're in good weak side rebounding position. Look at Winters working off the offensive boards. He goes to the line quite a bit.
So two free throws for James Winters. Leading Iowa in both scoring and rebounding, as you see, and that's his third point of the night. Had a career high Monday, 26 in the lopsided win over Dartmouth, 104-65, as Iowa tuned up for this game tonight.
I want to call for a tune-up with Madonna. You see Madonna College? They gave up 189 points the other day.
I thought you meant Madonna the singer. I was going to say, you better watch what you're saying. Your wife won't want you to come home.
Well, maybe she was playing. Maybe it was Madonna from out of Michigan. 189 they gave up.
Collins back-to-back trays. That's what he does best.
You can see why they wanted him here. He can shoot the three.
He had 37 threes last year, and he's 2-for-2 tonight, and now Clark comes up with Iowa's third turnover. Went to it one time, too many. He's back in front, though, by one.
He's improved his ball handling and defense, as you see the steal right there.
Boy, Collins, his dad is here tonight. He's really showing off for the old man.
Yeah, the dad's got to be proud. He's saying, that's my guy. I'll tell you one thing. He was one special player, Doug Collins, at Illinois State. Spread the court. Get into that good passing game, a lot of motion. And they look for that back screen to the post.
Hill pulls off the rebound.
See, here's his versatility. Can handle the ball, bring it down.
Clark will try it outside. And settles on the board.
Duke really shooting the three quickly.
Glasper, did he carry it? Yes. Another Iowa turnover. They started forcing Duke turnovers early, but now they've got three the last four trips down court.
Tom Davis was telling me Glasper was an outstanding quarterback, recruited by a lot of people out of Michigan, Albion, Michigan, in terms of football.
See some scores from elsewhere around the country. Florida State at halftime leading.
Get another cupcake. I mean, Pat Kennedy loading up on all those hostesses.
He's got to have those cupcakes before his point guard gets back. Charlie's still got one more football game to play.
You talk about Charlie Ward. What a role model. Just a super kid. And we look here at the three-point shot. They're Duke shooting seven, shooting 43%. Iowa 2-for-3.
Collins wants that ball. It's Lang who drives the lane. That's his first basket.
So athletic at 6'8", he can post the inside. They get a lot of mismatches when they play Meek, Parks, and Lang across the front.
Quickly, a four-point Iowa lead becomes a five-point deficit as Duke has turned on the gas. 13:38 to go first half.
White in the crowd as well.
Millard's going to back in and wheel on Parks. Nice move.
He was here early today. In fact, he was here about 2 hours prior to the other players arriving, working on his game.
They're going to call it a kickball by Millard as he got the steal. Clark trying to get the pass out of that double team.
He was redshirted as a freshman. Look at him. He's going to take the ball inside of Parks. He says, I don't care. You're a super Cherokee. He says, Chief, trying to get this, Chief. They call Parks Chief.
Clark still having trouble in that backcourt.
The one thing about Tom Davis, he will stay with that pressure.
Larry Rose and Lenny Wirtz talk it over. It is Iowa ball, Larry Rose says.
I think he got a walking violation on him. Let's see what he called. Oh, he went out of bounds. There's no such thing as a force out in basketball.
Larry Rose, Rick Hartzell, and Lenny Wirtz are officials tonight.
Come out of the ACC. Good spacing on offense, 15, 17 feet apart, getting good ball movement.
Kingsbury in the lineup now. He's a freshman who's also come out of the blocks well for Iowa. Nice feed inside. Bartles has it rejected by Grant Hill. He leads the club in blocks. He shows why there. Collins, that one rattled out. Parks on the rebound.
Always trying to make the extra pass.
Hill, nice drive, very smooth.
They really utilize dribble penetration. Duke likes to attack the gaps, and that's what Hill did right there.
Duke back in front by five as Winters wheels inside on Lang. A little bit short, and Parks will clear it off.
Parks has excellent hands.
Parks had 20 rebounds in a single game this year, and that was against Xavier.
He certainly was the difference against Michigan inside, and 23 points, 9 rebounds, and dominated the Michigan front court.
He only missed one shot in that game, too. Here he is outside. He'll try it. He missed that one.
He has stepped out in his game now. Last year, he was nothing but a block player, but now he's stepping out and shooting that jump shot.
Clark with a steal. Five Iowa turnovers now.
Grant Hill's going to be a sensational NBA player. 24-second clock, transition. He's the best senior in America.
By him playing this position just enhances his marketability in that league.
No question.
Collins, when he came in, 8 points in 59 seconds. Here's Marta Clark. Bartles a rebound. The three-pointers have gone a little bit cold now for the Blue Devils.
I think the Blue Devils are shooting the ball a little too quickly. I think they're going to make one or two extra passes, and they'll get a better shot.
Especially with the size advantage. Millard had it stripped by Hill.
So effortlessly. Look how smooth.
Nice pass over to Lang. Clark may have gotten away with a walk.
There's the extra pass right there. Rather than force the shot by Clark, he finds the open Lang, who's been missing the consistency.
7-point lead, and Bartles' three comes up short. As Duke stretched it out 22-15, 11 minutes to go first half.
Iowa's got to watch for a real spurt now in the next 4 minutes where the Blue Devils can put a real hurt on them. There's that zone. Play one man out.
The lob by Hill. Parks couldn't handle it.
Trying to take advantage of the size. Tried to throw the ball right over the top of the zone.
10:51 to go first half, and now it's Duke in front by seven.
This is official timeout on the floor.
Duke by seven. Seems strange to see Duke without number 11 out there playing point guard. Mike Krzyzewski had a chance to go out and visit his ex-star Bobby Hurley, and he gives us this report.
Yeah. He's doing great, and it was... You know, there's some humor in all this too, and Bobby will appreciate this, is that he's always run like crazy. I mean, he can't get tired, and now he's starting to walk a little bit, and he told me, he says, Coach, it's really tiring to walk. And I asked him, I said, I bet you never thought you'd say something like that, but Bobby, we love you, and all the guys said they're going to do their best for you.
And they're doing pretty good so far, Bobby, as they're out to a 7-point lead. And as Dick said, we all send our best to Bobby in his recovery. And I know it's a happy holiday, just that he's recovering. That's the good news. Millard underneath, going to get a second chance, maybe. Yes.
I'll tell you, he's playing really hard, Millard, inside. Big, strong, physical player, was redshirted as a freshman.
He's out of right up the street in Cedar Rapids. Went to high school there, 6'8". And Duke threw it away.
They lost so many players, Iowa, as you see a turnover, but they give it back to Duke. Look at Dr. Tom working that sideline. Went to Wisconsin, Platteville. Did an outstanding job at Boston College. Gary Williams worked with him at one time down at Lafayette College and also at Boston College as an assistant.
Tom's been the Big East Coach of the Year and the Big Ten Coach of the Year. Not too many people can make a claim to be a Coach of the Year in two major conferences.
Had that great first year, 30-5, but let's be real, we got to credit George Raveling and Rudy Washington now at Drake. They brought in all those great players, B.J. Armstrong, you talk about Lowhouse, and they had some club, Roy Marble, Horton.
Lang, baseline, got it.
Has he improved? What confidence?
Really has.
You can see his eyes. He's got such confidence when he touches the basketball.
24-17 again. Duke by seven. And we're past the midway point of the first half from Iowa City. Brad Nessler and Dick Vitale, nice to have you along with us tonight from Chile, Iowa. That one off the side from Kenyon Murray.
Went into a little zone right there, matching up to playing a little zone this year.
Nice steal as Millard and Murray converge to pick up the Duke turnover. Settles as it knocked away from behind by Hill and last touch by Settles.
Settles has really played outstanding basketball early this year. They're really high in his diaper dandy. Good athletic ability, very physical.
Another kid who played high school ball just up the road a piece as Collins sits.
128 kids in his high school.
That's right. Lang starting to feel it and going to work on offense. That one came out on it.
Duke really goes to that bench. Depth, size are the two ingredients they have, plus the most versatile player in America.
Winners in the paint. Rebound off the Hill and ahead to Kenny Blakeney, who just checked in.
Blakeney, a role player, good defensive player, has worked on improving his ball handling skills, redshirted in his freshman year.
Parks with a left hand. That was a nice move as he swept across the lane. He drew the foul. It'll be on Settles again.
There's a little hug right there. Parks has got to be a little active inside. There's the big fella showing his hand. Looks, says, give me the rock. Give it to me. I shoot 67%. Using the left hand inside. He's got to assert himself. He's got to shoot the ball 14, 15 times a game.
Shoots almost as well from the field as he does from the line. 70% free throw shooter.
He broke the heart. I mean, broke the heart of Jimmy Herrick down at UCLA. Hey, UCLA's been a machine this year with the two O'Bannons, Eddie and Charlie O, putting the show on. If they ever had this guy in the middle with Tyus Edney and Tarver, forget about it.
Parks out of Huntington Beach, California, has four.
He left California for Duke, just like Ricky Price will be there next year. Some say the best player in California, he'll be a Dukie.
The lead's ballooned to nine. Hawkeyes in need of some offense and a trap in the corner. And there will be a foul called on Capel.
They go to their blue defense, Duke, where they line up in a little 2-3 matchup and then trap on the wings.
Settles will sit, and Millard, who's done so well off the bench, back in. Millard right now leading Iowa in scoring with six. Capel on the drive, and a pin by Winters.
He got that ball as it was going up. It's a great block. In the NBA, that's a douche. You're not allowed to block a ball once it touches the glass. But as long as it's going up, it's a good block.
Jump ball, possession arrows, Iowa's.
Here goes Capel now. He's going to take the ball to the goal. Takes it up real strong, and there's the great Skywalker. He takes it right to the glass, gets the ball on its upward flight. Good rejection.
Parks had one of his own on the other end, but it will still be Iowa's ball on the baseline.
In the NBA, once the ball touches the glass, you can't get a piece of it. In college, you can.
Murray snuck a pass into Winters.
Oh, that's the ducking move. Simple ducking move in the 3-second area. Winters does a great job playing with his back to the basket.
Winters with 6 points to go with his five rebounds. And a foul on Murray in the backcourt.
The one thing Duke knows, the pressure will be tenacious all night long. He will not change, Dr. Tom. See, everybody says Duke doesn't have a point guard, but with the presence of Grant Hill, you have another guard on the floor at all times.
Gonna have to hurry. Just got it in on a four count there from the baseline.
Several years ago, that would have been a turnover because the rule was that the ball had to be touched somebody prior to five. Now it's just that you have to release it before five.
Lightning kicks it out to Hill. He's going to take it from 17 and got it.
Oh, he's getting more into his shot from his legs. He's using his legs a lot better. Last year, he was not a three-point shooter. He went 3-for-3 against Michigan.
I told him, I said, how many did you shoot last year, Grant? He said, I took four. I said, how many did you make? He said, three. Well, he's got six coming seven now on this season. So he's more than doubled his total output of three-pointers from a year ago. Bartles outside. He wanted the three and couldn't get it. Duke ball.
He's a 57% three-point shooter, Bartles.
Chris Kingsbury again will check back in. And we've got a break in the action with 7 minutes and 19 seconds remaining first half, and the Duke Blue Devils have stretched their lead to nine. Mike Krzyzewski in his 14th season at Duke and going for his 400th career coaching win tonight. In his 19th season overall, of course, it started at Army.
Hey, look at that picture. Wow, look at the general right there. I mean, he looks about 28 years old. You know, Mike went back there as a coach in 1976. He was 27 years old. He was a grad assistant at Indiana when they had their 31-1 team. Following year, Indiana went undefeated and won the national title in 76. But some say their team in 75 was even better, but Scott May broke his wrist.
All I can say is I love the do he's got there. That hairdo is nice.
Almost like my hairdo,
almost
huh?
Almost like yours. Coming out of the pile with a rebound is Glasper.
Montaire Glasper's got to be their little leader at the point guard slot. He's got to give him quickness and pushing the ball up the floor. He's got good ball handling skills.
Duke now in the zone. Let's see who can shoot them out of that.
They've rotated now back into a man-to-man. No, they're zoning right now. He's still zoning, still playing a double up on a baseline.
Winters over Hill, that's a tough shot.
I'll tell you, Winters really effective inside. He's become their number one option.
That's a tough shot with nobody on you, much less Grant Hill, the defensive player of the year in college basketball, in your face. 7-point Duke lead, 6:20 to go first half.
See, full court pressure, 80 feet and 90 feet, you neutralize size. But if they can get the ball 30 feet away, Duke, like they can right now, size becomes a factor. Iowa's got to try to beat him with that pressure and utilize the 90 feet.
Hill outside. Can't get it on the baseline. Great position by Lang, and he's going to get a chance for a three-point play.
That's exactly what I was talking about, Brad. Size becomes a factor if they play 30 feet away from the basket. They just have too much size, athletic ability inside for second and third attempts. If Iowa's going to be successful, they have to utilize the full court and force the turnovers. Look at Lang working on the interior. He didn't do that last year. Look at Tony Lang. He wants to go to the next level. Look at him working. There he is inside. He squares his low. I'm becoming a star. Coming special.
6'8 senior, one of the tri-captains for Duke. And Mike Krzyzewski would say this kid has given up a lot for the Duke program. He had to play behind some other great players, of course, that were there. And you can go back really 4 years, and he's put in his dues, former Alabama State Player of the Year in high school, and starting to show that now in his senior season. 10-point Duke lead.
Valedictorian high school, had a 4.0 average. Almost went to
just
Georgetown.
Like you.
Yeah, I had 1.0 as a freshman, 1.0 as a sophomore.
You went all the way through summer school to get it up to the 4-0, right? Yeah. Winters walks with it.
There's lifting that pivot foot prior to putting the ball to the deck.
As you said, though, he's the guy Iowa has to get it to. He's been the meat and potatoes so far for their offense tonight.
There's the full court pressure. See, right now you neutralize size. But if Duke's able to get the ball across the line and get into their offense, they have the advantage. Tough to match up.
Clark. Rebound to Kingsbury.
Kingsbury's going to be a very good player. He's got a solid body.
Give a nice feed to Winters.
Oh, yes! The Skywalker says, I'm going home, baby! They love that in Carver-Hawkeye Arena, Jam City!
Glasper averaging 5 assists a game. That's his best pass of the night. And all of a sudden, 15,000 back into it.
Got a turnover. Violation. 5-second violation. Watch the great entry right here. Glasper, the little quarterback. He dumps it down inside. Winters with the great legs. Takes the two. Legged bounce off the floor.
First 4 minutes, Duke didn't miss. 5 out of 15 since, but the last, Iowa rather, but the last couple trips down court, they have been able to put it home, and they have cut a 10-point lead down to 8, and they've got the ball in hand. Winters again, swapped away by Clark. Winters will try again. Score it this time.
I'll tell you, he's a big-time post player. He has excellent use of his body. He knows how to spread his body in the lane, and he knows how to finalize. Look at him use his butt right here. And then he knows how to get inside. He takes it right up at the 6'10". He protects the ball so well. For you young people, learn how to spread your body when you sit in that box and then protect the basketball with your body.
Already with 12 points, James Winters, a 6'5 senior out of Joliet, Illinois. He was on one of those European tours, too, with a group of Big Ten All-Stars. He led that team in scoring at 19 a game, and they had some pretty high-powered players on that team, too.
I'll tell you one thing, he's not intimidated. He is ready to play here.
He's got 13. It's a 5-point game. Again, the pressure is a problem.
See, right there,
another steal.
You take away the size. Timeout.
31-28.
Mike wants the timeout, too. He's been trying to get the timeout in the break.
Collins will try to quiet the crowd, but it's Iowa's rebound. Skillet. Ahead.
Oh, what a great pass! Gotta get a timeout! He needs a timeout!
On a 9-0 run the last minute and 45 seconds, Dick, with plays like this.
Well, Brad, here's how they negate Duke's great size with full court pressure into the trap. Look at Bartles on the floor. I mean, what a great steal. Pass by Kingsbury. Millard with the score. And then the great look by Skillet. The excellent bounce pass, the good hands, the finalization, the jam, the exclamation point by Mr. Look at Mr. Krzyzewski. Boy, I like Winters. Winters with that deuce inside.
Winters with 15 to lead all scorers. We're still in the first half.
Now they go to a half-court trap. Duke's going to get a lot of wide-open shots on the wings. There it is right there, wide open on the wing.
Collins buries a three.
Against that half-court trap, that wing shot will be available.
Collins leads Duke in scoring with 11.
You talk about a leader. Chris Collins is that kind of player. Very intense, mentally tough. Said his sister Kelly's quite a player.
Sophomore.
He says she's a gamer, coach.
Right. And Iowa walks with it. And that was really an unforced error as Kingsbury just took a step. Skillet takes a step.
That'll be a great game. Ralph Willard's club is outstanding at Western Kentucky, hooking up with Louisville, who they beat last year.
Duke, three of their last nine from the field. But they have quieted the crowd as they saw a 10-point lead evaporate down to a single point before that Duke timeout.
Iowa using Millard up at the point.
Parks in low, and he's pushed underneath. Coming up, more college hoops following us, the Maui Invitational semifinals. Ohio State, fifth-ranked Kentucky, will have at it at 9:30. Then Boston College and number 13, Arizona at midnight.
They're both undefeated. Could we go out there? Why don't they get a private play?
No. That's Saunders and Raft.
No, but let us go watch it.
We got to draw that duty one of these years, don't we?
I need a tan. I want to get a private plane and go out there and at least watch those games. Are you kidding me?
John and Bill will bring you those two when we are done here. Cherokee Parks, kind of quiet so far. He's done a good job boarding, but 5 points so far. Delta Fawcett halftime reports just 3:23 away. Highlights from Indiana, Kansas, Rick Pitino conversation, and a lot more in about 3 minutes, 23 seconds. And Duke in front by six now again.
Back in their man-to-man defense. Iowa does an excellent job reversing the basketball, sprinting the court, and trying to get that post move on a box.
Collision in the paint, and it's going to be Cherokee Parks.
Brad, when you think about what they lost, when you talk about, for example, Iowa, they lose guys like, well, A.C. Earl now doing a solid job with the Boston Celtics. They lost Jay Webb, Val Barnes. Certainly the passing of Chris Street, they were 12-3. In fact, you know what's ironic? Chris played his last game against Duke and made right. Two free throws at the end.
34 in a row,
a school record.
Here's Winters. Boy, he's been tough. That one doesn't go for him, and Lang way up there for the rebound.
I really like the improvement of Tony Lang. He's a different player than he was last year.
Got three boards to go with his 9 points.
They got to get the ball inside the park. See, they can't defend Parks inside. They don't have the size to play with him.
Hill for three. That one off the mark, and Bartles will rip it off the glass. Nice bounce pass over the corner. And right inside they go to Winters. He threw it away. Collins with a steal.
He's got a trailer.
Collins has had a nice game. Missed that double scoop.
Should have hesitated his dribble and just reversed it back to a trailer for a layup.
4-on-2 for Iowa. Bartles can't get the three, but they keep it alive as Settles pulls down the rebound. Murray. Whoa, that one way off.
Brick City USA right there.
Collins, did he walk? No, they're going to call a foul on Glasper. Kind of gave him a wing on the way by.
Now you talk about a kid that's been exposed to basketball, his dad being a great player, then coaching the Chicago Bulls, and Chris was the ball boy with the Bulls. That's certainly a player's dream. So many young kids to be around Michael Jordan every day.
Hill will inbound with 2:18 left.
Well, they could have had Parks for a push.
He pushed off enough to get open.
Yeah, he really did. He gave a little shove. He got away with one right there in the lane. They need a big score. It is a big possession.
Got to keep Duke from getting a double-digit lead.
Duke has gone on a 7-0 run of their own after Iowa had one that cut the lead to a single point. That's a three. Doesn't go for Clasper. Parks with a one-hand outlet, and he got it all the way down the lane. Nice pass.
That was a Bill Walton-style pass, that one-hand baseball pass, the length of the court, the great catch by Lang. Lang's going to create really a lot of problems for a lot of opponents this year with his size and his athletic ability.
Game of streaks so far, and it's Duke's streak right now. It's in order.
Settled down after that timeout. Mike certainly a lot of poise.
Millard in close.
I tell you, Millard's been really solid inside. He's going to get a lot more PT this year.
40-32. Down to the final minute. Carver-Hawkeye Arena.
It's the versatility with the basketball. Poise. Dad Calvin Hill, the great running back for the Dallas Cowboys.
Boy, Collins is feeling it tonight. Four threes in this half.
Somebody's got to tell the Iowa players that Collins can shoot the three. Nobody's
they should
up.
Know now.
They should know by now. Is right.
He's taken enough of them. And Hill almost came up with a steal. 43.5 seconds remaining. Coverage Sunday night of the NFL continues. Should be a good one. Joe Montana and the Kansas City Chiefs trying to get home field advantage in the AFC playoffs. Take on the Minnesota Vikings. Denny Green, former Iowa Hawkeye. And that's Sunday night, 8 o'clock Eastern. Both teams in the playoff hunt. Kansas City really in the driver's seat. Minnesota still trying to sneak in there as a wild card.
That's a big game for Minnesota. They need that W. Zone right now by Duke. Got a matchup. No, they're going to look for the three.
Now to 10 on the shot clock, 30 on the game clock.
Duke rotating out quickly to try and take away the look at the three.
Now they've got to hurry. Kingsbury, downtown Cedar Rapids, where he took from Winters the rebound. And they're going to call an offensive foul on Winters as Clark hit the deck.
Lenny works with that call. Watch Winters operating inside. There he is, the Skywalker. He's got the great legs. Now they watch. Ooh, catches him with a little elbow. Marty Clark.
And Winters told both Larry Rose and Lenny Wirtz, hey, you know, I came down, had the ball in my hand. I wasn't looking to do that. I was trying to get room for my body to land. And he loses the argument, as you might expect, and heads to the bench as they don't want him to get a cheap third foul here before halftime.
He looks like he was losing his pants, too. Everybody with those baggy shorts.
Hill, with 7 seconds left, rips it.
So smooth. South Lakes High School, Reston, Virginia. Grant Hill, a star from the day he walked on a Duke campus.
Iowa made a nice run, but Duke, thanks to Collins, 14 points with 4 three-pointers, has Duke out in front. 45-32, our halftime score as we head back to the studio and Chris Fowler. Chris?
Okay, Brad. Dixon, the Blue Devils survived that run, showing the same poise on the road that they did at Michigan when they beat the Wolverines in Ann Arbor. Stick around for the Delta Fawcett halftime report. We'll have highlights. Kansas and Indiana are playing as our Louisville and Western Kentucky. Plus, we'll hear from Rick Pitino as his Wildcats get ready to play out in Maui. It's Duke by 13 at the break. Stick around.
ESPN's exclusive coverage of NCAA basketball is brought to you by Millennium. We're leading the charge in rechargeables.
Carver-Hawkeye coming up in just a couple minutes.
A division of the Chrysler Corporation.
At the big game in Lawrence, the Jayhawks have pulled slightly ahead of Indiana in the first half. Patrick Ritchie will step in, make a nice steal, and take it the other way. And it's Kansas that's built a 5-point lead, now 7 and change to play at Foggy Island Fieldhouse. We'll continue to keep you posted on that. We're set, though, for the second half from Iowa. Let's return you now to Brad Nessler and Dick Vitale. Guys?
Thanks. Halftime here in Iowa City. The Hawkeyes trail the Duke Blue Devils. 45-32 is our score at intermission. And you wonder what a difference it would make if that man's son were here to take part in this ball game. That's Mike Street, Christopher Michael Street, his son. Chris Street would have been a senior on this team, and Tom Davis talks about the late forward of the Iowa Hawkeyes.
The tremendous team player. He was a guy that cared more about the team than he did about his individual stats. And
I never saw him have a bad practice or a bad effort in a game.
It was his last game. We admired him. Our fans really appreciated who Chris Street was, and our hearts went out to him. Since the accident to Bobby Hurley, we've gotten a lot of calls and letters from the Iowa community saying that they really are happy that the same thing didn't happen in that type of accident, that Bobby is still with us, and we really appreciate that. And
when I heard of Bobby's accident, you know, you just couldn't help but think of that. And I think, too, it's important. Duke, I think, represented what a lot of programs around the country, Mike and the kids, they did a great job of trying to help the Street family, and they had fundraisers for them.
There's a bond there between the two communities. It's kind of neat, based on a very tragic accident.
Dick, I did the first game back after the Chris Street tragedy last year, Iowa against Michigan State. They had to come from 17 behind to win, but they've got that same Chris Street spirit in this game, but they're down 13.
Well, you know, when you talk about Chris Street, you certainly talk about somebody that epitomized what coaches dream of. Play with great intensity, unselfish, certainly epitomizes the spirit of Bob Hurley as well. As we look at the dad, Mr. Street, I'll tell you one thing. I used to love talking to Chris when I'd come here to do a game because he was that special kind of guy who coaches dream of coaching.
In the first half, here's how the stats looked. Duke with the edge field goal percentage, and the rebounding edge goes to Iowa. That's not a surprise. They've led the country in rebounding a couple of times in the last few years. And those three-point field goals, though, especially Collins, really hurt near the end of the half.
Yeah, Chris coming off the bench gave him such an explosive output when he had 8 points in about 59 seconds. And then Duke made that real run at the end. As you look at spurts here, he called that timeout, Mike Krzyzewski,
right.
And then from that timeout, they dominated.
It was a 14-2 run in the last 4 minutes, 17 seconds of the half, and that's where Duke has it, up 13 now as we start the second half.
The next 4 minutes so crucial to Tom Davis and his Iowa team. They can't afford to have Duke go into a spurt where it'll be a blowout city, baby.
Collins.
Great size. He looks right over the defense or under the defense and makes passes. Hill is an excellent passer.
Parks came up a little bit short. Glasper will bring it down court.
I was going to find a way to knock down some trifectas.
They did early, and then they went cold from out there.
Well, Duke's doing a great job extending defensively to take away the look at the three-point shot.
Glasper, nice dish out to Murray all alone, but he missed the open jumper. Bartles will keep it alive. Here's the three. Well, they're getting the rebounds at least, but that one right back into Grant Hill's hands. And Capel will pull up for one of his own.
Jeff Capel, they expect him to be an outstanding guard. He's a combination guard. He can play either position. His dad is the head coach down at North Carolina A&T. Used to be an assistant at Wake Forest under Bobby Stack.
Lead has exploded out to 16 points.
Who plays that steady, tough man-to-man defense?
Capel overplayed that one a little bit. Winters an air ball from the baseline. And now it appears Duke's size is intimidating Iowa a little bit. Settles didn't even look to try to back in on Parks. And then inside, they did draw the foul.
Well, Mike was talking about their size today. He said such a unique look to this basketball team. And then Hill plays on the perimeter, gives him another big guy. Long arms at 6'8", leads him in shot blocking. Mike Krzyzewski, what a job he has done since his arrival in 1980. I mean, just amazing. You think of his first 2 years, 17 losses, came up short in recruiting, told me today how he lost Wennington and Chris Mullin to St. John's, was a little down, and then all of a sudden, Dawkins and Allery,
and all
they started
Billison.
The march. Then they added Amica the following year, and in 84, they started the hunt, baby, and they were gone. 86 to 92, 6 out of 7 years to the Final Four.
Grant Hill, fans think he got away with a walk. Foul in Iowa.
What makes Duke so special is they wanted to walk. You talk about a program that epitomizes what the NCAA believes in. Players graduate, everything's done with class. There's Peter Gaudette working that sideline along with Tommy Amica, who's behind Mike Krzyzewski, Michael Bray. Both of those guys, Bray and Amica, are ready for a head coaching job.
Right now, Duke with Capel, Collins, Lang, Hill, and Parks on the floor.
And the beat goes on and on. You should see their recruiting class coming in next year. Perimeter players, Trajan Langdon from out of Alaska, Alex Wojciechowski from out of Baltimore. See, Krzyzewski wanted a nice Polish boy.
Parks goes up strong, drew a foul. They'll call it, I believe, on Bartles underneath.
They wanted a little walk-in call on Mr. Parks. Look at the hugs. They love to hug. They love to hug one another. Kiss. You think they're talking about the game to say, hey, guys, where are we going to go eat tonight? Where are we going to go eat? We're going to have a good time tonight?
So Cherokee Parks will go back to the free throw line.
And Mike's saying, see, my team, they're together. They're talking about the game. They were off for 8 days since that Michigan game, and then they're going to be off for another 7 days before they play again against Western Carolina.
Great for them as far as final exams is concerned. They weren't quite sure how it would affect their basketball play, and maybe in the early going a little bit rusty, but I think that's all worn off. Parks has 10.
You know, so experienced. These kids have been through it all, but they're not going to be certainly intimidated. Playing on the road doesn't bother them when they play in a tough ACC schedule. And these are good tests for you. You play Michigan, you play Iowa on the road.
Yep.
That's how you get a true evaluation, as opposed to just blowing people out.
Winters in low, drew the foul. And Grant Hill went up with him.
I'll tell you one thing, Winters certainly has carried his load inside. He really is attacked Duke, taking the ball strong to the basket. But he needs some help from some of his perimeter players. Look at Winters. He makes himself big inside. Now he's going to attack the defense. And when you attack the defense, you hang, you got great body control, you're going to get fouled.
Millard's going to check back in. He could be the guy to help him a little bit inside. Winters already with 15 tonight, 3 for 3 from the line. As we said, his career high was Monday night, 26, and he might be on his way to that.
He's got to make free throws. You know, shooting 50% for the year on a free throw line.
Well, you talked him into that one. He was 3 for 3 before you made that comment.
Penn State's got a toughie. Look, Bethune-Cookman. Hey, my alma mater beating out Tony Baroni. The Italian connection, Carlissimo and Baroni. Who said all Italians are in the construction business?
Winters got the second. 16 for James. But it's still Duke by a big 16. Here comes that full-court pressure again. They're going to back off it now.
See the difference in attacking the pressure this year versus last year. With Bobby Hurley, they go through the pressure, 3-on-1, and they get layups. Right now, they bring the ball on the floor, and they get into their half-court offense. There's the lob inside. Count it.
Nice feed by Capel.
Great execution. 45-degree angle. Throw the ball on top. Get the little layup. Mickey Krzyzewski jumps off for chair. Says, that's my husband coaching.
The lead is up to 18. Murray drew the foul. It'll be on Lang.
Parks doing a great job posting. His granddad sitting right behind Mike Krzyzewski says, that's my grandson. Look at the Chief. The Chief's taking it up. He said, that's why I shoot 67%.
Great touch nice on that lob. Pass.
Millard has no chance. Rotation a little slow coming over from the help side.
Lang and Hill each with 3 fouls now. That could help Iowa down the line if they can get another one out of each of them.
I just don't see a run coming. I just don't feel it, Brad.
Neither is the crowd right now.
I don't feel a run coming. They're struggling almost with every possession.
Could really use a 3.
See, and Duke's not letting them get that good look for the 3.
Millard inside, and Parks with the foul.
Parks only going to have a matchup when he hooks up with North Carolina.
Ooh,
I mean, that's going to be unbelievable, that matchup, when those two hook up, Montross and Parks.
Coming up tomorrow, Top Rank boxing heavyweight action. Alex Zolkin and Jerry Lee Jones will have at it tomorrow night. That's 7:30 Eastern time, Top Rank boxing right here on ESPN.
You know,
at least it's not Jerry Lee Lewis that's fighting. That's the good news.
Jerry Lee Lewis, is he a fighter too? No, he's old.
I think he was, yeah. Millard at the line.
Great balls of fire, isn't he?
Goodness
I know my
gracious,
music.
You got it. Millard's first point of the half, but his 11th of the game. He really came on in the first half off the bench.
I think he's going to be a solid player, and I think he's going to get a lot more minutes and ultimately get their starting lineup to give him some size inside, because the Big Ten is such a physical league that they're going to need his strength. Big Ten is unbelievable. Northwestern right now is 8-0. Ricky Birdsong, what an experienced team.
Wisconsin's unbeaten too, right?
Yeah, they're outstanding, and they're for real.
Clem Haskins got a great club in Minnesota. We talked about Michigan, Indiana.
Ohio State's not bad either.
Capel, 3 is a little short. Ohio State will be playing following us. Millard had it, but lost it. He says Parks got a piece of him. The officials say he just lost the handle. And Russ is still chatting with Larry Rose down on the baseline. Collins. runs, wants it, launched a three.
Parks with a little push. They get him with the push.
Now he's got three fouls. So Parks, Lang, and Grant Hill, three of Duke's five starters with three fouls.
They'll bring Meeks in. Now watch. Watch Parks now trying to get away with one. Look at him. You can't get away with that. Get your hands away from there, Chief. You can't be allowed to do that. Now he goes City, becomes an assistant. He says, I really didn't push him.
So it's 52-36. That gives the crowd something to cheer about, the fact that those three top players for Duke have three each.
But they have such solid people coming off the bench.
Winters, great penetration.
I tell you, he blew right by Meek that time. I mean, he just exploded right by him to the goal for the jam.
There was a green light in there. No red and certainly no yellow. He went straight to the hole. And we've got a timeout with 16-12 to go, and Iowa's cut it to 14.
Magic Moments presented by the new Dodge. Some are born to lead, others to follow. But the late Pete Maravich was born to play basketball. The 6'5 guard with floppy socks and shaggy hair is still college basketball's all-time leading scorer. Pistol Pete averaged over 44 points a game at LSU, 10 points more than anyone else in history. Pete Maravich's magic moment came against Ole Miss on this 18-foot jump shot when he broke the previous college scoring record.
Win in Freedom Hall for the second year in a row, and they're getting it done so far. Darius Hall, big guy, gets it in the blocks, throws it down. It's a 7-point Hilltopper lead, 15 minutes to play. Brad, Dick will keep you posted.
All right, Chris, we had them first game of the year against Carolina. Dick, they're a pretty good club.
Hey, I'll tell you, Chris, they can flat out play. They got some outstanding athletes. With about 5 minutes against North Carolina, Ralph Willard's club was right in that game.
Grant Hill threw long, but Capel walked with it.
Yeah, he took the extra step. Lang being the leader now says, settle down, let's settle down.
There's the three-point shooting, and Iowa's going to need some more of that, some improved three-point shooting. And so far this year, they have put it up more than ever before, and they're going to need some threes before this one's over, it appears.
They came out at a shoot this year, shot 30 in their first game. Good game there, Kansas and Indiana. Roy Williams and the General hooking up. Syracuse with a blowout at home over Miami of Florida.
We're 4 minutes into the second half. It's a 14-point Duke lead in this one. Duke has a 4-0 series record against Iowa. Nice lob inside. Millard gives it right back. Nice ball movement. Winters with a score.
Excellent passing on the interior. Nice single reverse move by Millard in the lane to get the pass, to make the pass over to Winters.
James Winters with 20.
Winters just knows how to score inside. He's got that special knack. See, now Duke's got to recognize who their option on the floor is. Mr. Hill's got to take over right now with Parks out. Got to get the ball in Hill's hands. Nice.
Great look. Entry pass to Lang.
Thank you. Put the ball in Mr. Hill's hands. He created the opportunity for Lang.
That would have been a jam finger for anybody who got a hand on it. That had some zip on it.
You know, Hill's been playing with a little problem in the webbing of his thumb.
Mm-hmm.
On his right hand.
They even contemplated surgery on it. And Mike Krzyzewski says, we don't talk about little injuries, but it's really hampered his ball handling, and he hadn't said anything about it or complained.
Oh, there's the bump inside by Meek. Running worse with the call.
Meek picks up his second.
Come out of Escondido, California. There's Dr. Tom Davis. Had that great team in the year in 87 when Indiana won the national title. He lost for the right to go to the Final Four. They lost that year to UNLV in an unbelievable matchup. What a game that was in the Final Eight.
Tom in his eighth year in Iowa City, and right now just 11 victories from becoming the all-time winningest coach. Lute Olson, who was also here and did that in nine seasons, has the top mark with 168. Tom with 157 here.
They've had some outstanding coaches. Lute Olson followed by George Raveling, and then George followed by Dr. Tom. Lute Olson in that game, that's going to be a special. I can't wait to get to our hotel and watch. Undefeated Boston College and undefeated Arizona with the best backcourt in America right now. Khalid Reeves and Damon Stoudemire are the best tandem in the nation. Plus,
I love watching games with you because you talk through those broadcasts.
I try to do the color. I'm going to send you
right.
A bill.
54-42.
Attack it now. 2-on-1. Give it up.
Clark will do it himself. It can't be short. Lang had it rejected by Winters. That's not a good
smart play on Clark's part.
No, he should have given it up a little bit earlier to Lamb.
There's Murray with a pass, and he had it blocked by Grant Hill. So blocks on each end.
They had the numbers if you were looking and got it out, Pete.
Duke's going to settle it down a little bit. Mike Krzyzewski with a little bit of a frown on his brow. Collins for three. That might have been a little too quick. It remains 54-42, 14 and a half to play.
If there's one negative about Grant Hill on the floor, is asserting himself, taking over, and being that really hungry player. He has a tendency to be so unselfish at times where I firmly believe he can flat out take games over.
Now he's doing all the talking in that huddle. So maybe that's what he's trying to get from his troops right now, as Parks will check back in with three fouls, remember. And Capel comes back in as well. And Antonio Lang will get a breather.
You know, speaking of his senior class, it's really thin this year, Brad, when you look at it. Grant Hill's certainly outstanding, Eric Montross, and then there's a big drop-off when you talk about the NBA. I said it the other night, and I believe this, it's going to prompt so many kids to come out early and continue that trend of the past. In fairness, this class would have had a Mashburn, a Rogers, a Hardaway.
Glasper missed the free throw, but Iowa kept it alive, and they can cut this lead down to 10 points score.
You said a little bit earlier, they're an outstanding rebounding team. That's been a history of Iowa basketball.
Millard got up in the air and found Settles somehow.
Nice move by Settles without the ball. A lost art, especially for young players. Hey, they're making that little run.
Here it comes, 54-44.
It didn't look like they had that spark. And every time they make a little run, Duke seems to have an answer.
A double Parks, but he's still got it in with a left hand. That's a strong move down low by Cherokee Parks.
He's really taking his game out a little further, but he's certainly so effective on the box.
Millard, a little too strong, and Clark with the rebound. Capel pushes it. Got it to Clark. Clark missed in close. Rebound Bartles.
Nice look by Capel. Did an excellent job finding Clark.
Settles. Oh boy, jump ball.
What great
and
timing.
Grant Hill just went up and took Settles, the ball, and everybody else and brought it down to earth.
Super timing. Watch Grant Hill right now, number 33. He'll attack the basketball just like his dad used to attack the hole for the Dallas Cowboys. He says, let me get that rock. You're not taking it on me, Settles. This is not high school. This is not Winfield, Iowa. This is the big time now. Settles gonna be a heck of a player though. He really is. Montier Glasper sounds like a star.
Kingsbury trying to lob it to Millard, and he drew a foul. That's four on Grant Hill.
That is big. That's the leader. That's the catalyst. That's the guy. That's the engine. They're a beautiful Rolls Royce, but without Mr. Hill in the lineup, they become a nice-looking car. With him, they become a solid gold Rolls Royce.
There's the foul trouble. And Lang will come in to take his spot. So four fouls go out, but three come in.
They got away with one right there, though, throwing the ball over the top, trying to get it over Parks and Hill.
Well, Kingsbury did a good job selling that as a jump shot from outside and then fed it underneath to Russ Millard. He says his favorite TV shows, Beavis and Butthead and ESPN. Sometimes it's one and the same, probably, but he's back to the free throw line. Trying to cut the lead back to 10.
Beavis and Butthead, a good backcourt, can really play. They can shoot the jumper, huh? They're like Fowler.
I was
going to
say, that's what a lot of people
Fowler
call you and
Saunders.
I, but I left that alone.
Look at his fouls. Duke 9, Iowa 2.
Millard perfect from the free throw line.
Every foul from this point on will be every team foul. They're shooting two.
Russ Millard has just matched his career high and does it against the number three team in the country and cuts the Duke lead to 10.
See, there's something to be said for coming out early, work ethic. He was here real early this morning. Oh, nice pass, the skip pass.
Clark doesn't get it, Millard does.
Boy, I'll tell you, Millard is playing his heart out.
Murray, baseline, got it.
Knocks it down. And here comes the Hawkeye crowd, 15,000 strong. They want their 43rd in a row against non-conference teams.
All over Duke in the backcourt again. They got too close. Might be winners, but they call it on. That's his third. Iowa can ill afford to have him sitting.
Iowa 15-1 last year at home. They're a club that's got to protect their home court and get wins here because it will not be easy for them on the road. This is not a deep club in terms of size. They're a very young team.
Their only loss last year at home to Indiana. Everybody else they beat at least once around the Big Ten.
And everybody else lost to Indiana with the exception of Ohio State. It was 17-1 in a Big Ten.
Lang somehow shagged down that high pass from Collins. Collins jumper. Rebound, Kingsbury.
That shot right there by Collins really forced that one.
See if Iowa can cut it.
Yes, they can. Settles for three.
I'll tell you, settles up a lord. He is solid players. That young man number four is a diaper daddy.
And another steal. Kingsbury, he got it.
Count it. Get a T.O., Mike. Need a T.O. They're all jacked up, baby. They all believe.
It was 18 points. Now it's three.
And did I say that we're going to make the run?
Hayden Fry says, my football team can't score this quick.
Look at Hayden on that sideline. The coach, Dr. Tom, applauded the effort. Tremendous effort. The three E's. Effort, excitement, and energy. There you are with the steal off that pressure. Relentless, tenacious. Great play by Kingsbury, another diaper dandy.
The freshman a chance for a three-point play. He's got it. It's 56-54. Timeout. Mike Krzyzewski will talk it over. His team's lead's been cut to two.
Hi. Is this space taken?
No.
Then I'll sit down.
You want a Bud Light?
Not yet.
That's my Bud Light.
If you want great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
How about a little help here?
Dodge Intrepid has a steering system so advanced, it can actually sense how fast you're driving. At highway speeds, it gives you a more precise feel for the road. As you slow down, it adds power and makes turning and parking easier to handle. To get your hands on steering this sophisticated, have a seat. Dodge Intrepid. This changes everything.
Hollywood Pictures presents Kurt Russell, Val Kilmer, Dana Delaney, Powers Booth, Michael Biehn, Bill Paxton, Jason Priestley, Sam Elliott, and Charlton Heston. Nothing you've heard about the legend can prepare you for Tombstone. Rated R. Start Saturday, December 25th.
It's still tight in Lawrence for number six Kansas, Patrick Ritchie. Two of his 10 points in the first half. Kansas has led most first half. Right now it's a three-point lead at the break. Back to the Bedlam now in Iowa City.
It's getting a little bit crazy, Chris. 12 to go, and the lead has been cut to two. It was a 12-4 Iowa run the last 2 minutes, 15 seconds.
Well, Brad, we talked about the fact without Mr. Hill on the floor, Grant Hill, they're a different-looking basketball team. Look at this right now by half. Field goal percentage, Iowa up to 46%. Duke only 31 in the second half.
And a foul on Glasper before the ball was inbounded, trying to hold Tony Lang.
You know, now you look at the composition of this Duke basketball team. Not really super experienced. When you think of last year, they have a Bobby Hurley. They have a Grant Hill. Well, Grant Hill out of the lineup, sitting on a sideline as an assistant coach. Certainly not where Mike Krzyzewski would like to see him right now on the road.
Lakeney in a guard now. With Capel, Clark, Lang, and Parks rounds out the Duke lineup.
Very young backcourt in terms of game experience with Capel and for Blakeney.
Capel got three and nailed it.
That's a big shot by Capel. Stepped right into the gap.
And apparently we have a foul down low to boot.
Seems that every time Mike Krzyzewski hits the timeout, something good happens. Now watch Capel split the defense and then square his body. He's a good-looking freshman. He just has to get to really aware of the system, get adjusted to playing in the system.
It could have been a four-point play. Settles was called for the foul, but he also stole the inbound pass. Kingsbury. pulled off the backside by Winters.
They do a great job rebounding from the offside. Iowa always in good rebounding position.
Again, Duke forcing the action way out near midcourt.
See, I would go inside to Winters. I would slide inside Winters and let him post right now. He's a driving, slashing player. I don't want it up on top. He's got to give it up and go inside.
He looks up at the shot clock, which has 10 seconds. Antonio Lang all over him. He left it on the baseline for Murray, who had the shot blocked. It'll be Iowa ball.
See, I would have preferred, if I were Dr. Tom, if I were him on that sideline, that Winters give it off and slide inside and get it back to where he can be effective. Here he is playing out on a perimeter, handling the ball. Now he makes a good look inside, and Lang, with that athletic ability, attacks the offense.
Settles, takes a three off the inbound. Murray puts it back up. And going to have a foul underneath. Nope,
shot clock expired. Yeah. Shot clock expired. Put the hand to the head.
Settles three-pointer didn't touch anything. That's why.
Russ Millard in the hotline for James Winters.
Winters is going to get a breather. Millard checks in. I think they need Millard in there, to be quite honest with you.
Yeah, Millard's been such a steady player. They're trying to give him a little rest. He'll probably be in about a minute. Skillet coming in for Glasper.
It's a four-point game. 10:58 left. 58-54 Blue Devils. Two tremendous runs in this game by Iowa, though, have made it a ball game.
Iowa trying to pack it inside to Parks. They can throw it over the top, get the good angle of Parks.
Lang wanted it, got it, and missed the shot. It was halfway home, and it came out on him, and it's Iowa ball. Last touch by Clark.
Remember, right now, looking for 43 in a row, the Hawkeyes in non-conference play at home. See, here's a Winters got to assert himself. Oh, he's got Winters out of the game.
Pivot step.
Yeah, he brings Millard in and takes Winters out of the game. Back to Tom, who in Boston College in 82 lost to Houston. Phi Slamma Jamma for the right to go to the Final Four when he had John Bagley and company. As a look at Winters sitting down, getting a breather. Tom shuffles his players in and out. Uses that bench.
Come out in that zone again against.
They're packing it in inside. Parks got good inside rebound position.
Just going to say, against Capel and Blakeney out on top, and it's Capel that buries the three.
No, it's amazing. He's made the two big shots, Capel.
And he's got his team back in front by seven at the midway point of the second half. Grant Hill on the bench with four fouls, 11 points on the night. Tony Lang's helped to pick up some of the slack. He has 13. He's one of the tri-captains. There's the Duke senior class.
Look at that record right there. Two NCAA championships, two rings, 85% winning percentage, and they've played against some strong competition. The ACC being the premier conference in America. In fact, Dr. Tom said that today. He said the ACC, there's no doubt, is the best conference.
Settles missed. Millard was there to pick up the air ball, went back up and had it blocked. Did Blakeney step on the baseline? Yes. You know, that winning percentage and that number of wins, but think about what Leitner and Davis went through. 123 wins for those two guys from freshman through senior class, which is an ACC record.
Incredible. Since 1986, they've averaged about 30 wins a year. And it's only going to go on and on with the kind of recruits that they're bringing in.
Iowa needs a bucket badly. The freshman will try to get it and done.
Finsbury's got that strong body from out of Hamilton, Ohio. Young guy came out of there, went to Kentucky by the name of Kevin Grevy. Left-hand jump shot. They got some good-looking young players, Iowa. When you think of that freshman class and sophomore class, Millard and Kingsbury and Settles.
And they really hustle. But that loose ball picked up by Lang gives him 15.
I'll tell you, Lang's so active. Last year, he would disappear in the action.
Skillet thought about a three.
See, right now, they got to make a little run, especially with Hill out of the lineup.
Settles. Lang intimidated him a little bit inside.
See, I would get Winters on the floor quickly. I would use, well, here he comes now. I would get Winters, especially with Hill out of the game. Well, here comes Hill. He's matching. He decided to bring him out with 8:56. James Winters coming in, number 23. Great leg, strong inside post player.
So Grant Hill just checked in, and he will trigger it on the baseline. Had to lob it into Parks. Two on two. Capel's going to push it. Skillet picks up another quick foul.
I'll tell you one thing about Capel. He has really asserted himself here at crunch time. He made the big three. He made a big deuce.
Kevin Skillet, his second. Team foul number seven.
Skillet, two fouls, and he will take a seat on the Iowa bench. And Duke with a 63-56 lead under 9 minutes. And Jeff Capel, the 6'5 freshman out of Fayetteville, North Carolina, who draws a striking resemblance, I think, to Jason Kidd, doesn't he?
Yeah, the facial, he does really look a lot like Jason.
8 points all this half.
I mentioned Jason Kidd, he made that big shot to beat Duke in the second round of the NCAAs last year. Made that sensational play. But they've been one of the early season disappointments. Oklahoma State's been a little early season disappointment.
Cross-court pass, Kingsbury, a three, won't go.
Can't come up empty. They're just struggling, trying to get back in the game.
So, 2 3-pointers that go astray by each team. Comes Iowa.
I don't think Duke, Brad, has taken advantage of the size inside of Cherokee Parks.
Kenny Blakeney picked up the foul. That's his first. And Duke with over the 10 foul limit.
Tom Davis also talking about the toughness of the Big Ten in terms of the balance. He said the ACC's been probably the better conference. He said, however, we certainly are going to be very strong from top to bottom this year. And they are. It's not going to be any automatics. I mean, you go to Penn State, it's not automatic.
Russ Millard, 6'8 sophomore, played at Washington High School in Cedar Rapids, which is, I don't know, about 30 miles up the road, I guess. And he has a career high, and I'm sure he'll always remember it. He'll break this career high the way he's been playing as the season goes along. But when you get 15 against Duke, you've earned your keep.
I tell you, it was so impressive watching him here early this morning. I came right from the airport to the arena, and he was the first guy in the gym working out all by himself. I had a chance to share some time. So there are young people out there. If you're really chasing a dream and you want it to happen, you have to have work ethic.
Iowa almost made it a three-point play, but missed the stick back, and it's 63-57. We're approaching 8 minutes. Brad Nessler and Dick Vitale, Carver-Hawkeye Arena in Iowa City. Fans trying to get up for the defense here in the late stages of this ball game, as Iowa's going to need one more run, and they've had a couple of beauties so far tonight.
See, right now, Parks has got a flash to the open area in that zone.
Hill, his jumper goes.
I'll tell you, he's like automatic from 12 to 15 feet. He's got that great touch. What an NBA player he will be. Great attitude, coachable, winners, skilled.
Winners, the hook over Parks. Collins will pull it off the backside.
They like tease you, don't they, Iowa? They run, make that run. The crowd really gets into it. But then the crowd gets quiet when the kids really need them, when they're struggling. You and I were talking about that during the break.
Yeah.
You got to watch the lob go into Parks. You got to watch the lob go into Parks.
Grant Hill again, short. Millard pulls off another rebound. 5 rebounds for Millard to go with his 15 points. Well, the no look ended up being a ricochet off to Bartles. And Collins pushes him.
I also lost a good point guard they were counting on, Kevin Smith,
Kevin
academically.
Smith, right?
They lost a lot of players from last year's club. Hey, you talk about Duke. There is nothing like Cameron Indoor Stadium. We go around the country, but when those 9,314 get rocking down here at Cameron Indoor Stadium, it is really special. In fact, one of the writers wrote about it today from up in Iowa. Said he went to a game at North Carolina when Iowa played, and he went to a game at Cameron Indoor Stadium. He said, let me tell you something. The building shakes.
Bartles is 0 for 3 from the free throw line. He came in 50%. Maui Invitational next. We talk about Ohio State being a good club. They got their hands full with fifth-ranked Kentucky. And then Arizona and BC will square off in the nightcap at midnight. John Saunders and Bill Raftery out in Maui. They'll bring you those games following this one from Iowa City that has 7 minutes remaining.
I mean, they get Maui and we get Iowa City.
Yeah,
a little difference in the weather.
A little bit difference. I'd say probably about 90 degrees.
A little sunshine, a little beach. There's that 2-3 matchup. Swinging it side to side. You can break the defense down if you're allowed to make the ball reversal.
8 on the shot clock. As you see in the corner of your screen, Hill will probably be the man to take it and bury it.
He wants it. He wants the ball. He knows I'm the number one option. Give me the basketball, and he makes the big, tough shot.
Still, it's a single-digit game if Iowa can find a way to score, and Tony Lang's just picked up his fourth. So now Hill and Lang with four. Parks still on the bench with three.
And Grant Hill touches him on the head. Now look at this. Tough shot. Splits the defense. Takes it right between the seam of the two. Squares the body. Rotation. Jumps. And his dad jumps and says, wow, my guy. Look at the seniors. These are probably the best seniors in America in the eyes of all the NBA scouts. Hill, Montrose, Carlos Rogers, very special. 6'11". Aaron McKee can flat out play. Deion Thomas, the all-time scoring leader at Illinois. Thinness in that class, though, for the next level, but not this guy. Special.
At that nice little hang time when he puts that jump shot up too, doesn't he? Doesn't come down to earth until the ball is almost through the net.
And it's so beautiful to see a young man like Grant, who possesses more than just basketball skills. He's one of those guys you just know he's going to make it beyond his basketball days.
This is the guy for Iowa this year, averaging 20 points a game and has 21 tonight. To go with 8 rebounds.
Well, he did his job tonight, Brad.
Sure did. 15 in the first half. Had 7 points and 6 boards in the loss to Duke last year up at Cameron.
How quiet is right now?
Millard will check back in, and Winters will come out.
Duke's got to be
a 7-point game.
Yeah, got to be careful at a one spurt. They're hanging and hanging right in there. They need the crowd. The crowd has got to get behind them while they're behind. That's it. Now the crowd is into the game. Look at this guy. Three-quarter trap.
Boy, they just barely got across and into the front court. That was about a half second to spare. I was watching the shot clock, which now has 13 on it. Capel, he's hit some big shots tonight. Not that one. Millard, another rebound.
The other great ingredient with Duke is they have a lot of interchangeable parts. Guys can play a lot of positions.
Blakeney with a shove.
Not allowed to put a hand on him. Blakeney played in a great program down at DeMatha under Morgan Wooten. Certainly one of the premier coaches in all of high school basketball.
Glasper will go to the free throw line to shoot a couple. He can make it a 5-point difference. Kansas and Indiana having at it. There's that. Louisville now has come back to lead Western Kentucky by 5.
Cincinnati with a tough one, Miami of Ohio. Syracuse blowout city. Whoa. Doubling the score. Wow.
Glasper rips that one.
How good is Boston College? I mean, they went up to Syracuse and put the hurt on the Orangemen. Find out tonight. They play undefeated Arizona.
Iowa is helping themselves from the free throw line, that's for sure, because Duke got that early bunch of fouls, and they're over the limit, so it's 2 every time. It's a 5-point game.
They just keep hanging and hanging and hanging. You can't knock them out. There's that trap. Now he's going to back away from the trap and throw the diagonal pass. Smart move.
Tell you what, they're making Duke use 9 or 10 seconds, though.
And it's only a 35-second shot clock, so now you got to hurry once you get into this area.
Exactly. Settles on Hill. 7 on the shot clock.
They missed Lang. Had Lang inside. He finally gets called.
And he just said, give me the ball, man. You called it, Dick. He just looked at Marty Clark's screen. Give me the ball. So Millard picks up the foul. That's only his first, as tough as he's played tonight. Only has 1 foul.
Here comes Parks back on the floor. You know, you look at Millard's body, and you would think that Hayden Fry would sprint on a court and grab him and say, I want you as a tight end. Look at him. He's going to mug him right here. I mean, he lays a body on him. Look at Lang. Says, get him away from me. This is not football.
There's the coach, Hayden Fry, head coach of the Iowa football team, and they were booing him here when his team was 2-5. They won their last 4, and they're going to the Alamo Bowl. I think that's great.
There's so many bowls. You go 6-5, play in a major conference, you'll find somewhere to play.
Bartles thought about a 3. Glasper penetrates. Nice dish.
Oh, great look by Montaire. Montaire, the magician, with the little handoff inside.
Only a 3-point difference.
Oh, could have been a turnover. Never had possession. Good call.
Marty Clark's really struggling here tonight. He's really struggling.
He has to split through a double team, and again, it's under
25 seconds when they get it into the front court. 20 on the shot clock, 4:35 on the game clock.
They go to a double stack with a 1-4 setup with Hill out front. See, with that 5-second no count, he can play with the ball as long as he wants and just back you down.
And take you to the hoop? No, he kicks it out to Collins. In and out on the three, Clark keeps it alive.
Great
Lang
pass.
In close.
Super pass by Marty Clark. He's been struggling, but makes a big play right there with the nice dish to Lang.
5-point game, 4:10 to go. Millard doubled, kicks it out. Murray for three. And Glasper on the rebound. There's a nice pass to Settles. Millard, yes.
It's Millard working inside, but what a magician. Mr. Glasper is Montero with that nice bounce inside. Here comes that pressure. There's a deflection.
Foul call on Millard. He thought he knocked the ball away and forced a turnover, but he didn't.
He made some contact, and he knew he did it. And you're not going to get away with that with Lenny Wirtz, too experienced as an official. He will not be intimidated on the road.
Lenny's been officiating since Santa Claus.
Look at this right here. I mean, he makes contact right there. He's over the top of Mr. Parks. Watch the magician right now. Watch Montier. The little handoff like a QB. He was a quarterback in high school. Millard is the conversion man. He converts.
Boy, you got to be ready for his passes, don't you? Cherokee Parks got the roll. 15 for the game for Cherokee. And perfect from the free throw line, 7 for 7.
You know, I salute these Iowa kids, Brad, because they could have rolled over when they went down 18. In fact, I thought at that time it looked like they were ready to roll over. The crowd got quiet, but they've been hanging, and they're 5 down with 3:51.
They're going to have to make one more run in the next 3:51.
Indiana and Kansas, Patrick Ritchie on the wing will miss, but Allen Henderson loses track of the big guy. Greg Ostertag was there for the follow. 15 and a half to play. Jayhawks still up 4. Brad?
The agile Greg Ostertag. Here, Iowa fans know they've only got 3:51 left to scream. They might as well scream the whole way for Tom Davis and the Hawkeyes, who have not quit at all tonight. They trail 71-66. And the second half scoring, 15 from the line and only 19 from the field. They need some three-pointers sometime before this is over. They'll take a 2 right now, but Bartles is too strong. Winters, he can't get it either. And Parks a rebound.
They had the perfect execution, ran that horizontal screen, got the good bounce pass inside, had the layup, but Bartles hesitated, and then Winters should have taken it right up, made a spinning move inside. I'm going to spread the court, put the ball in Grant Hill's hands. They use some of that 35-second clock. Tom Davis is going to let him use it and play in a 2-3 zone. See, here's where Parks has got to make himself available. You got to really flash to the ball. You got to want the ball at this time.
Lang does. He missed it. He and Winters, Parks and Winters go up, and it'll be Duke ball.
Yeah, I hate the alternate possession rule. I really despise that rule. I think it takes away effort. It just rewards somebody by pure luck wherever that arrow's pointing. I wish the rules committee would get that out of the game. There's the weak side rebound. Now coming over, there's Cherokee. You got a jump ball. Let the refs throw it up now. Make it exciting. Make the coaches have to make a call in terms of set plays.
As it is, a fresh 35 for Duke to use some clock. If they can get it inbounded, they do. 71-66, we're under 3 minutes. Duke trying to go to 6-0. Iowa trying to pull off an upset over the third-ranked team in the country.
It's really tough almost to talk, though, about upset whenever you're on a road in the Big Ten or the ACC, because you should protect your home court. But right now, Duke's certainly the better basketball team personnel-wise. See, with the 5-second count now, we can't do that.
Backdoor Collins flies over.
Charge. Collins out of control.
That's his third. Gives it back to Iowa with 2.5 minutes to play. Millard held his ground.
Now Iowa's got to really play intelligent with the basketball.
They walk it down the other way.
Oh, he's going to shoot these. It was not a player control foul.
So Millard will walk up to the free throw line. And he's 5 of 6.
He's in the stripes. They're going to have a bonus.
Russ Millard.
His career night just keeps getting better.
He was practicing those free throws this morning, early in the morning. Cold as can be outside, but he was in this arena working and working. Good things happen to thou who works hard.
Ripped them both. It's still a three-point game.
And there he is up on the baseline.
And again, the backcourt pressure.
Put it back in the hands of Grant Hill. Spread the court. Millard's coming out to check him in a half-court trap.
Down goes Kingsbury. No call. Collins lines up for a three and nailed it.
Big three. Poised right there by Hill. Makes the extra pass. Reverses it to Collins.
Collins with five threes.
That's what he does best.
Kingsbury trying to answer and can't, and Lang the rebound. And now it's down under 2 minutes.
And when in doubt, just flip it over to Mr. Hill. Throughout his career at Duke, he's been in these big, big moments.
Clark blocked by Winters. Iowa ball.
Winters made a great effort to make that play happen. There's Winters with that great effort. Clark takes it to the goal strong. You know, the one great thing about Duke, everybody plays hard in terms of coaches really work hard to get people to play with great effort. But it's a difference playing with a great effort and playing as a unit and as a team. And that's what Duke does. They play hard, but they play as a unit.
Winters wheels on Parks. Had it blocked by Grant Hill, and now the possession arrow will go Iowa's way.
And there it is, being penalized, playing good defense. You block the shot, but because the arrow's going that way, you lose it. And that's exactly what I'm talking about. So Freddie Barraquette, who does a great job in the ACC, he's involved with the officiating. Freddie, use your power, help in this rule. Get the rules committee to get it out.
Winters double team, goes up high over Parks. Millard, tough rebound and score.
I'll tell you, Mr. Millard, he's my player of the game for the Hawkeyes. Russ Millard, what an effort tonight.
Clark's alone. Winters is going to have to foul him. Nope, he lets him go.
Good catch right there by Marty Clark. Interesting how Marty Clark, you can see the guys that Mike Krzyzewski believes in late in the game. He's got a lot of experience now on that floor.
We're down to a minute. Iowa may need some three-point shooting pretty soon, and Bartles is their best three-point shooter that's on the floor.
Millard again. Russ Millard. I mean, is he working on the boxes inside?
He's got 25 points. He just shattered his career high with 25 tonight off the bench.
And now he's the point of the pressure. There he is with his great size on the trap. Well, that pass has got to be stolen. That high lob thrown laterally.
76-72.
So you got to deny the ball to Hill. Don't let Hill touch the basketball. Bartle's got to come up and try and deny him the basketball.
Don't forget Ohio State and Kentucky follow us in Boston College and Arizona. Hill backpedals. It's a three-pointer. And it goes up over the backboard. Iowa ball, 23.3 seconds left. They're down four. They need two possessions. Here's what's coming up next. Maui Invitational. Ohio State in fifth-ranked Kentucky, then 18th-ranked Boston College, and number 13, Arizona. And Arizona is a team that has something in common with these teams. The last team to beat Iowa here in non-conference play, Arizona. The last time Duke won a lost a non-conference regular season game to Arizona. Murray penetrates, leaves it. Settle scored.
A lot of people say, why not the three? But you're down four. That's a good move.
Need two possessions anyway.
Only two possessions is right.
Now let's see if they foul right away. They do. They foul Parks. He's perfect from the line tonight.
Didn't have to look for the three in that possession. Look at Collins. He's coming over here to us. What's he going to do? He said, check the monitor.
He said, we're not losing.
Well, we're not losing. That's what he said. Uh-huh. He's just like his dad. What a competitor. His dad was one of my favorite players. Watch him play for Will Robinson, Illinois State, and then in the NBA. What a great effort by Tom Davis's club, but certainly this game's not over. As the nice little dish inside. Murray with the dish.
Strong move by Settles for the two.
Settles and Millard give him some good play on the interior.
Sure is.
And so does Winters.
There's a timeout. Parks is going to have to wait for his free throw. 12.7 seconds left. It's Duke leading by two. Brad Nessler and Dick Vitale in Iowa City, where the Hawkeyes refuse to quit. 12.7 seconds left. They trail by two. Each team with a timeout remaining.
Cherokee Parks will be going to the free throw line. And that is a jersey change. That's still James Winters, though his jersey is going to say John Carter. He apparently had some blood on his jersey. He has changed to number 30, but that's James Winters, the senior. And there's the timeout story, each with one. Team fouls both over the limited 10. Possession arrow Duke and Cherokee Parks. Perfect 8-for-8 from the free throw line.
They got to hope for one out of the two at least that he misses here.
Not that one.
He's like Automatic on that line. Confident. Steps up there. Look at Mike Krzyzewski. Look at the intensity in the eyes. Don't worry. Don't foul.
Iowa needs a miss here to have a chance for a three-pointer to try to send it to overtime. They didn't get the miss, so they still need two possessions. Blakeney will check in for Duke.
Good move by Mike Krzyzewski. He's going to go to a little full-court pressure now, Brad, to take time off the clock to make them struggle to bring the ball up the court so they can't run it up quick, get a score, and then foul.
Winters missed the three. Inside, Settle scores it with 3.3 seconds left.
Clock stops after the score here. That's the new rule. In the last minute, the clock stops.
Two-point game, and everybody holding their breath. Did they call a foul or did...
No, Tom Davis called
for a timeout. He got the last timeout. He got the last timeout.
Even though the clock stops, he wants the timeout to get some strategy.
Well, Iowa could only hope there'd be 33 seconds left. We're missing the point in there. 3.3 seconds remaining in the game. Strategy's been set. There's what Duke has done in the regular season against non-ACC teams. As I mentioned, the last time they lost was February 24th of 91 to Arizona. And the last time Iowa lost a non-conference game at home, 1987-88 season to Arizona.
Got to be careful. You don't want to throw the ball right now in his backcourt and allow him to get a look and a steal and a score. Get the ball up the court.
They got it right back to Clark. Nice give and go. 0.4 seconds left. Marty Clark will go to the free throw line. And
dangerous
stranger
area.
Things have happened, but it's hard to get a ball the length of the court in 0.4.
Dangerous area, too, and making a pass right under the basket. Get the ball up the court. Even if I was to make a steal up on the other end, would not have sufficient time to come back down and get a score. There's the hug. They're saying, we're going back to dorm. He said, we're going to light up that bus. We're going to get to the airport. We're going to go back to dorm with a big W, celebrate Santa
Claus. Take 8 more days off.
Wow.
Got another long break coming up. Maui Invitational, semifinals, Ohio State and Kentucky. Coming up next, just a tick, less than a tick away for you.
Hey, have a great Christmas.
You too, partner. Marty Clark, that'll do it.
They made their free throws here at stretch. Michael Kay going for his 400th. And he's so young. He's only 47 years of age. Mickey, I'll tell you, he's got a wife that's a dream to have as a coach's wife. And I'm sure she's celebrating right now, sitting at home. She usually makes a trip, but it's Christmas time. She's got to go buy Mike a gift.
Well, if Clark hits this one, even a length of the court shot by Iowa would not prevent this one from being a Duke victory. But he missed it.
They got a shot. There it is.
Settles.
Great, great effort, though, by the Iowa kids. They played with tremendous intensity.
He says, I still feel like a young guy at Army that I have to prove myself every night. Well, his team proved it again. They withstood another big rally from Iowa, and they win it 79-76. For Dick Vitale and our entire ESPN crew, have a great Christmas, everybody. From Iowa City, let's send it back to Chris Fowler.
And same to you guys. So Duke goes to 6-0. Reminder, we'll send it to Maui.